Tom Phillips is it. Okay, so it's called Living American Composers. The second piece you'll be playing is called Arabesque, which is by Samuel Hazo. And Arabesque is not based on American themes at all. It's based on Middle Eastern music. So it's composed in three parts. The first one is called Tazim. The part two is called Duke. And part three is called Kura. The opening flute solo is the Tazim, using a harmonic minor scale, a modified harmonic minor scale with microtonality bending of pitches to represent Middle Eastern musical traditions. The second part is the Duke, or traditional Arabic line dance performed at weddings. The final section is the choral, where it combines the Duke and Tazim, leading to a powerful conclusion. So this is Arabesque by Samuel Hazel.
Thank you. Thank you.
based on an energetic theme in the meter of 7/8, based on the concert C blues scale. It's driving rhythms that goes to the rhythm of it, and a connection to the growth of jazz and blues in America. The jazz genre originated in New Orleans, then migrated north when New Orleans musicians traveled the new rail lines and other forms of transportation all the way north to Chicago. One of those railroads was the Magnolia Star on the Illinois Central train line, and it ran from New Orleans to Chicago. You will hear the sax section evoke the sound of the railroad whistle and the low brass representing the locomotive steam engine in full throttle, Magnolia Star.
Thank you.
April 10th through the 13th is a play called Purple Hearts, directed by Nick Bradford from the theater faculty. On April 14th will be the last concert of the semester for the Wind Symphony. We'll combine with the Copper Country Band, and we will share the podium with Janet. That should be very, very fun on April 14th. ASO is going on a tour. Orchestra going on a tour to Crystal Falls, Algoma, Milwaukee, and Chicago. It should be very in the lead for many, many, many weeks. I never heard before. That was funky. That was awesome. It was good. Let's give it another hand.
Thank you.
Angels in Architecture begins with a single voice singing a 19th century Shaker song. I am an angel of light. I have soared from above. I am clothed with mother's love. I have come to protect my chosen family and lead them to the past. This angel, represented by the singer, frames the work, surrounding it with a protective wall of light and establishing the divine. Other representations of life played the light, played by instruments rather than sung, include a traditional Hebrew song of peace, Hevenu Shalom Aleichem, and the well-known 16th century Dunedin Psalter, Old Hundred. These three borrowed songs, despite their varied religious origins, are meant to transcend any one religion, representing the more universal human ideals of peace, hope, and love. An original chorale, appearing twice in the work, represents my own personal expression of these aspirations. In opposition, turbulent, fast-paced music appears as a symbol of darkness, death, and spiritual doubt. Twice during the musical drama, these shadows sneak in almost unnoticeably, slowly obscuring and eventually obliterating the light altogether. The darkness prevails for long stretches of time, but the light always returns, inextinguishable, more powerful than before. The alternation of these opposing forces creates, in effect, a kind of five-part mantra form: light, darkness, light, darkness, light. Just as Charles Ives did more than a century ago, Angels in the Architecture poses the unanswered question of existence. It ends as it began. The angel reappears, singing the same comforting words as before. But deep below, the final shadow reappears, distantly, ominously.
Thank you.